Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're exploring an application called Otter Notes, which aims to record some of your meetings, interviews, lectures, and translate them into text. It is an application that I know a lot of people will be talking about, especially on Twitter. So today's feature, we're diving into Otter Notes. So guys, just before we dive in, a big thank you here, July 2019, to Monday.com. Monday.com is an intuitive team management platform created to fit any team and manage anything. And why do teams love Monday.com? Well, Monday.com is easy to use, get set up. It is perfect if you want to pick from hundreds of ready-made templates or even build your workflows from scratch. And the platform is so customizable, it can be adapted to pretty much any situation, no matter the industry. It's used by a whopping 70,000 teams worldwide. From WeWork to the Discovery Channel, it's ideal for just two people building a business to large-scale teams to centralize their efforts. Now, if you guys are actually curious about how it works, we've done a walkthrough. You can find it in the description below. And if you do want to check it out, you guys can get 10% off using the code or link below, which will give you access to Monday.com. I just wanted to thank Monday.com for coming on and sponsoring, and I hope you enjoy checking it out. So guys, Otter Notes, let's dive in. Now, Otter Notes states it's going to be a way for you to generate rich notes for meetings, interviews, lectures, and other important voice conversations. And it uses an AI-powered system. Now, just to be clear, this is not going to be your Evernote replacement, but it's an application you probably wish you wanted inside of your Evernote experience. Now, of course, we know that Evernote has an audio recorder. Well, Otter Notes is, I guess, an entirely new experience, and we're going to be diving into that today. Now, you're probably wondering where I first discovered it, and that was mainly on Twitter. I saw a lot of people talking about it. And then it was an event in Cambridge, I think it was, and I saw someone using it, and I thought, yeah, okay, actually, I probably need to check this out. Tend to just go off my sort of feelings for this sort of thing. I also saw it featured in the Apps We Love by Apple this year, so that's always good news when it's featured in Apple. Now, there are two experiences to this. There is teams and individuals, and today we're going to be focusing on individuals. But with teams, it allows your teams to create meeting notes and organize interviews, so I'll include as much information as possible about that. Now, the pricing, you get 600 minutes free transcription time, and in the premium, that's $9.99 per month with 6,000 minutes and more bonus features. We'll be talking about that near the end of the video. And as I said, this is not a note taker per se. It's more of a way for capturing anything from the interview you're doing to being able to record some of your own personal notes. So I have played around with this a little bit. It is available on web. So here we are with otter.ai. That is the URL. As you can see here, once you create an account, you have a stream of your conversation. So you can go into the conversations you created and get started. So we're actually going to show you how to go ahead and create a brand new note in here. So that's probably a great starting point. All you have to do here is press start recording. Now what it will automatically do is go ahead and create a note. So let's say we're having some interview feedback. So as you can see, the recording has started and automatically the actual recording is being transcribed in front of you. And actually, I was pretty impressed when I first tried this. The previous note, which I'll show you, it was transcribing at a pretty fast rate and being able to get quite good quality transcription. So this could be like actually ideal if you're using this to actually take minutes for meetings or even actual interviews. So let's see how this works. So as you can see on the screen here in front of us, it begins appearing this large paragraph and actually just monitors it as it goes to be able to judge how I'm speaking. And as you can see here, you can change the note title up here in real time. Now it will give you information about each of these, like what day was taken, and you have what's called a counter. So down here, you can obviously see your voice moving around. But you also have the time. And obviously that 1 minute is going towards my 600 minute limit in the free account, which is fairly good, I'd say, as a good starting point. And just be aware, on Twitter, they do have some referral schemes that allow you a bit more. So down in the bottom left-hand corner, you have the ability to share it anyone with a link, which is quite useful. And you can choose when it specifically starts. You can invite names of people or emails or groups or anyone with the link specifically, which will get a sort of Evernote-esque sort of viewing option, which is actually very beneficial. Now, over in the right-hand corner, you can add photos. So obviously you can take them from your files. So for example, if I wanted to be able to add any of the photos, let's see what they look like. If I go and press open, they are added. And as you can see, they appear in line inside of the text, which is really handy. And as you can still see, it's still transcribing what I'm saying at a really good speed, I believe, in my opinion. So down at the bottom here, you do have the ability to highlight. Say, for example, any text you select could be the whole thing. It could just be, for example, if I wanted to select, I don't think you can select specific areas. It depends on like sort of the sentence you said. You go ahead, press highlight, and it will bring that up. Now, the other experience you can do is to copy it. And that's if you wanted to be able to share it with someone else, which is quite easy to do. And that's really the core features when you're editing. Now, you can give it a pause. So as you can see, it all sort of captures from there. So it won't record anything I'm doing now. But if I want to resume the recording, just takes a moment or two to be able to detect when the audio has started. So it should, there we go. It should be writing. And the good thing is it pops a little timestamp down there too, so that you are indicating in what period of time the recording actually started again. And I've purposely been trying to give it a bit of a tester, and you're seeing that actually it's pretty accurate at being able to detect that. So let's go ahead and press stop. So once you stop a recording, it'll sort of transcribe everything, and what it will do is actually go into what's called in processing. Now, if we take a look at the My Conversations view, it'll tell you how long the recording was, how many images are attached, includes one image, and what the status of the feature is. Now, just while it's processing, which takes a couple of minutes, of course, that's natural. And as you can see, I've got meeting notes here. So I'm just going to minimize this sidebar. So you can see here that this is the meeting notes. It actually detected the speaker. So automatically you get, if you've got more than one person in your meeting, for example, you just put the recording on, you can actually associate it to certain people and what they were saying, which is good. So it not only transcribes in real time, but it also records. So here's the recording.
So today's meeting is something that I want to address. I wanted to talk about some of the issues.
Now, what's quite nice about this as well is you have it highlighted. I believe I highlighted it, but it also runs through the words as they were said, which is really good. And I didn't find any problems with this. Now, when it comes to playing back, you can also do 1x speed, 2x speed, and 0.5x speed, as well as skipping silences. Actually, that's a premium experience. But also, when you click on any of the premium experiences, you get an idea of how many minutes you have left. So collectively, I've used 4 minutes collectively across all of my usage. So that's really handy to know. Up here, I can also add keywords. So keywords are a great way. It automatically generates keywords and it produces almost like a word cloud. So for example, if I wanted to select a tag for it, then I can. It automatically summarizes the keywords inside of there so I can go and find them. So for example, if this was mentioned several times throughout this, I could go and pan through using the search ability up here. Now, if you do want to search for something very specific too, like if you want to check how many times you said how, you can enter that and it will automatically pick out in the sort of playback when it is available in. So that's really good. You can go ahead and edit this as well. So if you wanted to be able to modify, let me just see whether you can. Yep, there we go. If you want to be able to modify any of the notes and add additional stuff, that's something that you can do. So that's actually quite a neat feature. Now, if I go ahead and press done, as I said, I can share it up here, but I can also go to this sort of drop down here and move it to a certain area. So for example, if I had a folder, in which I don't at the moment, you can create folders and groups over here. Let's say you wanted to create a marketing folder, then that's really easy to do so that you can organize your conversations. Let's go back in and move that to marketing. So you can see it's been moved to marketing, which is really easy. Let me just knock that down. And you can also export your text. Now you can export it in a variety of formats, including PDF, clipboard, SRT, and include speaker names, include speaker timestamps, and merge same. So this could actually technically be used as a YouTube, for example, if I wanted to transcribe all my videos in better quality than my sort of experience now, then I could do. So that's exporting the text abilities. You can actually export the audio. So you can see here that it automatically uploads it there. So if I go down here as well, I can rematch the speaker. So if you've got multiple speakers in a group, so for example, if you and your team has that, you can automatically do that too. That's quite smart. And you can also delete that note right there. So if I go back and we go to the recording we just made, you can actually see the images, these keywords it's detected, and a full outline of what was mentioned. Now, as you can see, this is going to be a little bit of a longer recording. So as soon as you move the play bar, the playback, it automatically moves that around. So let's actually go back to my conversations and actually go on importing a certain video or a certain audio file. So let's say I want to import a podcast that we had. So let me just find the podcast. So that I can that could be it. Let's see whether that's it. Yep, that looks like it could be it. So as you can see here, you can import audio. So for example, if you had a YouTube video, maybe some lecture slides that the sort of lecturer sent to you, then you can do so, and audio as well. So as you can see, the size of the files, you can see that there, and the progress it's making, and naturally get a status of it. So as you can see, it's just been uploaded. If I press done, it will begin uploading that. So that's something we'll come back to in a moment. Okie dokie, guys. So whilst we wait for that to upload, I will just explain a few things before we dive in. So as you can see here, you've got the Otter plans. So these are the monthly paid pricing plans. So on the free plan, you got everything I demonstrated to you, and one feature that I didn't explain, which was syncing Zoom Cloud recording. So if you have Zoom Cloud and you back up your recordings automatically, then you can sync with that service. And that's really handy, because if you wanted to automatically do your video meetings, then you can automatically have that. Now, there you go. Transcription minutes are per month. So 600 minutes, I think, is pretty reasonable. I thought that was overall. So you're actually going to be using it pretty decently, I think, in my opinion. So premium features, you in the premium, which is $8.33 if it's billed annually. If it's billed monthly, it's $9.99. You get everything inside of the basic, and also 6,000 minutes, which is plenty in my opinion. You get custom vocabulary. So for example, if I kept saying keep productive and it detected that as keep it up or something like that, which commonly happens on YouTube videos, you can add custom vocabulary, which helps improve the understanding or detection of the word. You can integrate with Dropbox, which is something I know a lot of people will actually really like, being able to export all of their existing audio that they've done into Dropbox as a backup. Actually use the skip silence, so what we mentioned before, being able to save a bit of time when listening back, and more playback options. Bulk export, so if you want to take all of your notes and export them. Prioritize support via email, which is something very beneficial. Then there is a team plan, which is $14.99 per user per month, and you need to have a minimum of 3 users. So you're looking at about, here's my math, $47 per month at minimum pricing. You get all of the features, you get 6,000 minutes per user, all of the pro features, but you get centralized billing, user management, user statistics, shared speaker voice prints, 2-step authentication, and also live capturing for events, but again, that's an additional fee. Now, let's go back to the actual recording we've done. So let's see if it's been processed. It was 21 minutes long, so that is probably going to be a little bit longer to do. So here we are at steel cord, but I've slept. What? I hope it's gotten this one quite good. So there we are. So it's starting to understand it. It's still processing the audio, but you can see the conversation it's automatically doing with timestamps. So actually, from the conversation memory, it looks like it's doing fairly well. But we'll see. Well, maybe we'll come back to that or share a link in the description of that file dump. Anyway, guys, that is Otter Notes. I was actually looking forward to reviewing this, and I am actually impressed. I'd recommend this for those who have regular meetings, those who want to save time on any form of transcription, whether that's you just talking your notes up, or whether that's you actually recording a lecture, or even uploading some form of multimedia. For example, if you are someone in class who tends to upload videos of lectures or something else and want it to be transcribed instantly, as long as you own the sort of access to it, that's absolutely fine. The other thing I would note is just a bonus thing is I have not checked out their privacy policy. Now, privacy and security is very important, especially when it comes to storing recorded files and notes. So I would definitely recommend checking it out. I've briefly gone over it and there doesn't seem anything untoward. I've also checked Twitter as well and nobody's sort of saying that it's like the Google Drive sort of IP situation. So, but again, it's totally up to your own situation. So please check it out, especially if you're part of a organization or even an education board. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. Check out Otter Notes. I'll include a link in the description. And I will talk to you guys very, very soon. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone.